Dear students, I am continuing the problems in rank correlation. In the previous discussion, I had taken two cases of non-repeating values, and here today in this class, I am going to discuss about rank correlation calculation with the repeated numbers and how to calculate the rank correlation when the values of x are repeated in the same x column and y values are repeated in the same y column, and another type of data also when ranks are given already, then you need not to assign once again rank, such problems, and also more than two cases, that means more than two series of observations, when three series of observations values are given, then how to find out the rank correlation, that also let me explain. Then for the repeated case of values of the variables, we discussed like this. Find the rank correlation. Find the rank correlation for the table of values. As x and y values, similar to previous type of problem, x and y values 68, 62, 64, 58, 75, 68, 50, 45, 64, 81, 80, 60. 75, 68, 40, 48, 55, 50, 64, it is 70. Solution. When once you get the data, then don't be in a hurry to apply the equation r equal to 1 minus 6 times sigma d square divided by n into n square minus 1. You have to understand the type of data given, whether it is a case of repeated numbers or it is a case of non-repeated numbers. So here, for example, if you observe from the x series, 68, only one term appeared, 64, here also it is appeared, 64. And here also it is appeared. Then 75 is there, 75 appeared here also, then next 50 not appeared and 80 not appeared. And in the Y series 62 only once appeared, and 58 it seems once appeared, and 68 here also it is there, and here also 68 is there. 45 once appeared and 81 once appeared, and 60 also once appear. Therefore, you need to write the formula. You can write, this is the case of, this is the case of repeated values of x and y. This is the case of repeated values of x and y. That means in x separately and y separately. Therefore, therefore, rank correlation is given by, that is capital R is equal to 1 minus 6 divided by n into n square minus 1 and sigma d square, that is plus of m1 square minus 1 by 12 plus m2 into m2 square minus 1 by 12 plus so on. Here all the values already we are defined in the equations. What is capital D? That stands for R1 minus R2. Then M1 stands for number of times first number, first repeated number occurs, and M2 takes first second repeated number, number of times
the first repeated number occurs. Similarly, M2, the second repeated number, and so on. Let us see how this formula is going to be applied. Then you need to prepare the table, then X and Y, then R1, it is R2, R1 minus R2, it is D, and it is D square. Take the entry of the same values and assign the ranks in the increasing order, that is 68, 62, 64, 64, 58, 75, 68, 50, 45, 64, 81, 80, 61, 80, it is 60, then 75, 68, 40, 48, and 55, 50, 64, 70. Up to these numbers, you have to take the entry. Then, you have to assign the ranks for these numbers. Then, choose the highest number from the first one. That will be like first highest number in this. That is 80, should be taken as 1, and next highest number that will be taken as, that after 80, then you will be getting 75, but it appears twice, 75 here and as well as 75 here. Therefore, how to assign equal ranks? How to assign equal ranks means you have to take those two successive numbering type, and then you have to assign the equal ranks means mean value you have to take, and then you have to use it. The mean value will be, that is 75 you are supposed to rank it as 2, and this 75 you are supposed to rank it as the next number, but you have to give the same number. For 75 it appears 2 times, implies M1 equal to 2, this is first repeated number, and rank you have to assign like this, is equal to 2 plus 3 divided by 2, the mean value you have to assign. This becomes, it is 2.5, you write 2.5 here, and for 75 it is 2.5. Then what is the next highest number? That is after 70, then you have to go for, that is, this is a 2.5, you have assigned for 75. The next highest number is, that is 68, that should be 3. So that should be the next number, that is 2 is over, 3 is over, that should be 68. It must be 4, because 1, 2, 3, 4, and next number is, that is 64, that 64 is repeated here, then repeated here and repeated here. Therefore, the second repeated number, this is for 75, for 64 you have to consider, for 64 you have to consider, that is 3 times, 3 times, then this implies M2 is equal to 3. Then what is the next rank number you have to give? That is up to 4 you have considered. Then next is 5. How many times it is appeared? 3 times. Then 5 plus 6 plus 7 rank is equal to 5 plus 6 plus 7, because 64 appeared 3 times, then divided by its mean value, that is equal to 6. Then you write it 6, 6 and 6. then up to 7 already you have chosen. Total number of paid observations are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1 to 10 only you have to assign. So up to 7 already you have chosen. Then the next highest number will be, that is to be taken as, that is 55. Up to 7 means 8. Then this 50 is 9 and this 40 is 10. This is the method of giving the ranks. First highest number has 1, second highest number, and it is repeated, that is 2 plus 3 divided by 2, and third highest number is 64, that is appeared 3 times, then you are taking that as m2 is equal to 3. Then rank is equal to 5 plus 6 plus 7 divided by 3 is equal to 6, that is for m2. Then you go for y column. In this highest number is, that is 81, you must name it as 1, and the next highest number, that is after 81, in this column you will find 70, this is 2, 70 last number at the bottom, that is equal to 2, and then next highest number will be, that is 68, it seems 68, how many times it is appeared? That is 68 here, and then here for 68, it should be the continuation of giving symbols like M1, M2, M3, M4. Now for 68, that implies 2 times it is appeared, and M3 is equal to 2. Then rank should be, next number should be, it is 68 after 1 is 2, 2 is given for 70, next number is 3, rank is equal to 3 plus 4 because 2 times divided by 2, it is 3.5. Then for 68, 3.5 you write, and for another 68, 3.5 you write. Then up to 4 you have chosen, the next highest number after 68, that is 62 here, that is up to 4 you have taken, this is 5. After 62, then you will be getting as 58, that is 6. Then is after 58, next is 50, that is 7. For 50 it is 7. Then after 50, that is 48, 8. And 45, that is 9, 60 we did not count, after 3.5 is 4, after 4 that is for 68, then 68 means it is 62. This should be 5. After 62, that is for 60, this is 6. Then 58, this is 7. Then it is 50, that is 8. Then 48, that is 9. And 45 is 10. This is how the ranking must be done. Then you need to take the difference between these values. How to take the difference between these two values means R1 minus R2 or R2 minus R1, because you are going to make anyway, it is whole square. Then 4 minus 5 is minus 1, this is minus 1, this is minus 1, this is minus 1, this is plus 5, this is minus 5, this is minus 1, plus 1, 0. And it is 4. If you make square of these values, that is 1, 1, 1, 1, this is 25, this is 25, this is 1, this is 1, and this is 0, and this is 16. This total comes to be, here also this total comes to be 72. Then you need to apply the formula for repeated, for the case of repeated ranks. Then repeated ranks, the case is
R equal to 1 minus 6 times sigma d square. That is 6 divided by 10 into 10 square minus 1, because n value is 10, and multiplied by sigma d square, means that is 72. Then plus of m1 is 2 into 2 cube minus 1, and divided by 12 plus of, that is 3 times that number is appeared, in this case 64. That is 3 into 3 cube minus 1 divided by 12, and plus of 2 times, because this number is repeated, that is 68 in the second set of values. 2 into 2 cube minus 1 and divided by 12. So close the bracket. Then rank correlation, here it comes to be the answer 0.545. Here also it is greater than 0, because rank correlation or correlation, what kind of values you are getting, you just mentioned that negative or positive, depending on that you give your conclusion. If it is positive, then you say that it is positive correlation. If it is negative, then you say that it has a negative correlation. Let me go for another type of data, otherwise one more set of values here for rank correlation. Find the rank correlation for the table of values. It is given rank for x. It is slightly different type of data. Ranks for y, it is given. Here this problem consists of, already ranks are assigned. Ranks are assigned means here 6, 1, 3, 2, 4, 5, 1, 5, 2, 6, 4, it is 3. Like this already ranks values are given, so that you need to calculate only the difference between them and then make square and then substitute in the formula. So that here also numbers are not repeated, already ranks are given, even then the numbers are not repeated. This is also the case of non-repeated values. Therefore, in the solution, R is equal to 1 minus 6 times sigma d square divided by n into n square minus 1. Therefore, already ranks are given. This is R1 directly you take, and this is R2 you take. Then R1 minus R2, you have to simply calculate. That is R1, R2, R1 minus R2, that is for D, and then you have to write it as D square. You take the same entry of the data and then calculate the corresponding differences. R1 is for X series and R2 is for Y series. 6, 1, 3, 2, 4, it is 5. 1, 5, 2, 6, then 4, it is 3. Then you take the difference between these values. 6 minus 1 is 5, 1 minus 5 is minus 4, 3 minus 2 is 1, this is minus 4, this is 0, this is plus 2. Then make the square of this, 25, that is 16, 1, it is 16, 0, 0, it is 0, 4. Then you can take the total of this, 11, 12, 18, that is 22. 2 plus 2, 4, 5, it is 6. Then it is the value 62. Then how many values are there? To take it as n value, n value is, that is between 1 to 6. N is equal to 6. This is sigma, it is d square. Then you need to write R1 is equal to 1 minus
6 times sigma d square, that is 6 into sigma d square is 62, and divided by n equal to 6, and 6 into 6 square minus 1. This is for direct application of the formula. The answer comes to be 0.77. This is capital R. Rank correlation is the value, that is 0.77. This is also positive. There exists a positive correlation. Then another type of data, that will be the last type of data I am going to select in this. You can expect for the examination point of view, you can expect these types of problems along with this last problem also with equal importance. In the last problem, more than two series of observations are given and the ranks already assigned to the values, and you need to calculate the pair of judges where the common numerical value you are getting, and you can write that which pair of judges have the nearest approach to say that common taste of music or competition ranking or something like that. Okay. Then the problem is like this: 10 competitors. 10 competitors in a beauty contest context are ranked by 3 judges. In the following order, means this is first judge, second judge, third judge, like that. These values are given, already ranks are assigned. Those ranks are 1, 3, 6, then 6, 5, 4, 5, 8, 9, 10, 4, 8, 3, 7, 1, 2, 10, 2, 4, 2, 3, 9, 1, 10, 7, 6, 5, and the last one 8, 9, 7. These are the ranks values are given. In some context, the judges have given the ranks for the 10 competitors in this order. Now, the question is, which pair of judges have the nearest approach which pair of judges have the nearest approach to give the common liking in decision? Use rank correlation method.
Here, this problem is not for two series of observations, this is more than two series of observations.
For example, if you treat this as R1 and this as R2 and this as R3, then R1 is for X series and R2 is for Y series and R3 is for Z series.
But the formula we have defined for finding the rank correlation is for two series of values, that means X series of values and Y series of values. Only two series of values, that formula is defined. Now what you have to do is, there are three judges, you take two judges at a time and make a combination of that. How many such combinations are possible? Then using those possible combinations, you go on calculating the rank correlation value using that standard formula, and then see that numerically among three pairs of judges, because three pairs are possible from this, like R1, R2, you can make a combination, and next is R2, R3, another possibility, and last possibility is R1, R3. Then these three possibilities are there, then you need to calculate the values from these three pairs of judges. Then the next step, you have to write like this. You have to choose two judges at a time, that is R1, R2, R1, R2, that is R1, R2 means you have to take the difference, R1, R2, R1 minus R2, that is for B, then make B square in this and then take a total of that. Similarly, R2, R3, then you make this R2 minus R3, this is for D, then B square, next is R1, R3, then R1, R3 means R1 minus R3, you have to write. Then this is also D and D square next column. Then make a total of all these values. Then if you go on taking in this order, that is R1, R2, that means you have to discuss these two columns. 1 minus 3, minus 2, 6 minus 5, 1, 5 minus 8, minus 3, 10 minus 4, 6, 3 minus 7, minus 4, 2 minus 10, that is 8, with minus, this is plus 2, this is plus 8, this is 1, and this is minus 1. Next is R2 minus R3, 3 minus 6 is minus 3, 5 minus 4 is 1, plus 1, and 8 minus 9 is minus 1, 4 minus 8 is minus 4, and 7 minus 1 is 6, 10 minus 2 is 8, and 2 minus 3 is minus 1, 1 minus 10 is minus 9, and 6 minus 5 is 1, and 9 minus 7 is plus 2. Then R1 minus R3. R1 minus R3 means 1 minus 6 is minus 5, 6 minus 4 is minus 2, 5 minus 9 is minus 4, 10 minus 8 is 2, 3 minus 1 is 2, and 2 minus 2 is 0, 4 minus 3 is 1, 9 minus 10 is minus 1, and 7 minus 5 is 2, and 8 minus 7 is plus 1. Then you need to make square of these values, 4, 1, 9, 36, 16, 64, it is 4, 64, 1, plus 1. This square 9, 1, 1, 4, that is 16, 36, and 64, plus 1, and 9, that is 81, and then 1, it is plus 4. Then it is minus 5, that should be 25, that is 4, 16, 4, 4, 0, this is 1, this is 1, this is 4, and this is 1. This total, and this total you have to take. Then
for rank correlation from individual values you have to take what is for R1 rank correlation, then making the total of that, that is R is equal to 1 minus 6 times sigma d square divided by n into n square minus 1. Therefore, n is equal to here 10. That is 10 commutators means here 10 pairs of sets of values are there. N equal to 10 you have to choose. Then R is equal to 1 minus 6 times sigma d square divided by n into n square minus 1. Then in this case you have to write for the first combination, that is for R1 and R2, for R1, R2, you have to write the separate rank correlation calculation. You take the total of this, that is d square here, that is 9 plus 1, 10, 10 plus 1, 14, 14, that is 4 plus 9 plus 1, 10, 14, plus 6, 20, 26, 30, 38 plus 2, that is 40, and 4 plus 3, 7, 7 plus 6, 13 plus 6, that is 90, it is 190. Then here in this column, that is here 1 plus 4, 5, 5 plus 6, 11, this is 17, 17, that is 4 plus 1, 5, 6, 7, plus 4, 7 plus 4, 11, that is 17, 18, 19, plus 6, 25 plus 9, 25 plus 9 means 34, and 3 plus 1, 4, plus 3, 7, plus 6, 13, plus 8, 214. Then this calculation, that is 10 plus 5, 15, plus 8, 23, that is 25, that is 30. Then 3 carries, 3 plus 2, 5, 5 plus 1, it is 5 plus 1 is 6, then 60. That is 190. Here itself we can make out this summation and this summation are almost very close to each other. Then sigma d square in this column, this is sigma d square, this is 190, and sigma d square, this is 214, and this is 60. That means easily you can make out these two are very close to each other. Let us find out the rank correlation between these values. Using that formula, first of all, R1 and R2, that is R is equal to, for this case, minus 0.5. It is 21, and that is R2 R3, that is correlation R2 R3 for this capital R is equal to, that is minus of 0.20, and for R1 R3 that is minus 0.29, minus 0.29, and this comes to be 0.6. Therefore, these two, that means R1, R2 and R1, R3 have the nearest approach. Nearest approach in giving the decision. You need to verify these values, because numerically you have to check all these summations and values, so that which numericals are very close to each other, then you can write that. So R1, R2 and then R1, R3 have the same type of likings in giving the decisions. So this is last variety of rank correlation calculation. Next topic in this statistical methods is regression analysis. In this regression analysis, what we study here
the regression analysis is nothing but plotting the given data in the form of line of best fit.
So far you have taken these regression analysis discussion by forming the line of best fit as equation of straight line, but you have the data as you had in correlation, as you had in rank correlation values. So the next topic is regression analysis. It is the estimation of a new value using the given set of tabulated values. Given set of tabulated values. Let x naught, y naught, x1, y1, and so on be the given set of values, given set of values such that the line of best fit for estimation is the straight line. Is the straight line. What is that equation of straight line? That is y equal to a plus bx, or y is equal to ax plus b. Then here a and b are arbitrary constants obtained by method of least squares. Method of least squares. What is that method of least squares? That is nothing but sum of the squares of deviations. Is minimum. Sum of the squares of the deviations is always minimum. This is called method of least squares. Then, what is the regression equation for this? This is line of best fit. But what is the regression equation when x and y values are given? Next, equation for regression line. There are two regression lines are there in the curve, means there are nothing but straight lines. One line like this, another line. This regression line, first one will be y in terms of x and second one will be x in terms of y. This is x and this is y. For example, this is y is a function of x and this is x is a function of y. There these points are lying, maximum points are lying along that. They are regression lines. Then what is the equation for regression lines? Here also no derivation. Then you need to take directly the formula. How that formula defines for regression of y on x and x on y. So first equation, that means equation for regression line equation for regression line, that is y equal to f of x, the first one. This is given by y minus y bar is equal to r into sigma y by sigma x into x minus x bar. This is called regression of y on x. That means left side y is there, right side x is there, and all other values are numerical values, but only x and y are unknowns. That leaves the final step as y equal to fx. That means an equation connected with x and y. Then you need to write this finalized form. Y minus y bar is equal to, it is byx into x minus x bar. This is called regression equation in alternate form, where byx is equal to r into sigma y by sigma x. This is called the regression coefficient. Regression coefficient. Then, what is the another form of regression line? This is for y equal to fx, one line, and another line, that is x minus, you can write regression line x on y, that is x equal to f of y. Then x minus x bar is equal to r into sigma x divided by sigma y into y minus y bar, or x minus x bar is equal to bxy into y minus y bar. This is called regression of x on y. This is bxy, a regression coefficient bxy, sigma y instead, sigma x comes in numerator and sigma y comes in denominator. These two symbols are called regression coefficients. But regression equations are regression of y on x in the form y equal to fx, and regression of x on y in the form x is equal to f of y. This is the type of writing the formulas, and the lines of regression is these are the equations. So as usual, the every equation takes the calculations. Here x bar you have to define, and sigma x you have to define, and r value you have to define, that is correlation, and y bar you have to define, and sigma y you have to define, and here r value is common. X bar is nothing but arithmetic mean sigma x by n, and y bar is sigma y by n, and sigma x means standard deviation, that is summation x minus x bar whole square divided by small n, and this is square root of sigma y minus y bar, that is whole square, and divided by it is small n, and r is equal to that is correlation by the direct method you write, sigma capital X into y divided by square root of sigma x square into sigma y square. This is the formula, sigma y square. Already you have studied in the correlation, the same equation we are going to use. Whenever x and y values are given, and then you need to calculate the values of x and y, like arithmetic mean of x series, arithmetic mean of y series, standard deviation of x series, standard deviation of y series, and the correlation coefficient. So let us calculate the regression coefficients for this for various data. Then let me take the example on this, means problem on this. We will write what is the regression equation for various types of pairs of observations, that means values of x and y.
Here, the data is given like this. You have to consider the regression equation, how in this form will be that set of values of x and y will be given. Then you need to calculate x bar, y bar and the value of correlation, then regression coefficient. Afterwards, you can estimate new value by the equation that you are going to form. Now, the data will be like this. Find the regression line y on x. Y on x and find y at x equal to 6.2 given that x and y values will be appeared, that is x and y 1, 9, 2, 8, 3, 10, 4, 12, 6, 13, 8, 16, 7, 14, 9, 15. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight values are there. 1, 9, 2, 8, 3, 10, 4, 12, 5, 11. One more. 5, 11, 6, 13, 8, 16, 7, 14, and that is 9, 15. Okay. Then regression like y on x means it should be a functional relation as y is a function of x. In the solution, it is regression of y on x is given by, that is y equal to function of x. Means y will be the dependent variable and x will be the independent variable. That means y minus y bar is equal to r into sigma y by sigma x into x minus x bar. Then this is r value sigma x and sigma y, that is r into sigma y by sigma x is equal to v y x, that is regression coefficient. Then you need to prepare the table to find out x bar and y bar and then correlation value, and afterwards you need to calculate the standard deviation of those values, and then you calculate what is the regression line of y on x and x on y, that is taken as here x bar is equal to sigma x divided by n. This gives, that is 5, and y bar, that is equal to sigma y, take the sum of all these values, sigma y by n, that takes the value as 5, and then r value, that is coefficient of correlation, that is 0.95, using the formula, that is sigma x minus x into y divided by square root of sigma capital X square into capital it is Y square. Then regression coefficient you have to calculate, that is BYX. For this problem BYX value is given by 0.95. That means this BYX is nothing but R into sigma Y by it is sigma X. This is already taken as regression coefficient, this value comes to be 0.95. Then regression equation is given by, that is this y minus y bar, y minus 5 is equal to byx, that is 0.95 into x minus x bar, that is also 5,
and so that y is equal to 0.95x this much plus 7.25. This is called regression equation, regression of y on x. It is in the form of y is a function of x. The new value which you are going to calculate at x equal to 6.2, this implies y at x is equal to 6.2 is taken as 13.14. You check all these values, how this regression equation is going to be formed and how these calculations are to be taken, and then how this new calculation, that is y at x is equal to 6.2, is to be taken and how this formula is to be verified. Then second problem I shall write on different type. Both the equations, regression equations, are to be taken, that is find the regression equations. Find the regression equations of y on x and x on y, x on y, for the values, for the values tabulated values given like this, that is 1, 2, 2, 5, 3, 3, 4, 8, and 5, 7. Solution: in the previous example you had written only one equation, but in this example you need to write both the equations, that is regression of y on x and x on y. Two equations you have to write. Then how to take these two equations for regression forms, that is regression of y on x implies y is equal to f of x implies y minus y bar is equal to r into sigma y by sigma x into x minus x bar. And similarly, this is regression of x on y implies x is a function of y, should be, you interchange x and y, x minus x bar is equal to r into sigma x divided by sigma y into y minus y bar. So you need to calculate x bar and y bar. Here x bar is equal to sigma x divided by n is equal to, you take the sum of all these 5 values, 5 plus 4 is 9, 10, 15, there are 5 values, divided by 5 is equal to 5, and y bar is equal to sigma y and divided by n is equal to 7 plus 3, 10, 10 plus 8, 18 plus 7, that is 25, and divided by 5 values, that is also 5. Then here you are getting, that is regression of y on x and x on y. You need to calculate the standard deviations and correlation value, but correlation value I am going to write, it is 0.8. then byx, regression coefficient for the first one, this is to be taken as byx, and this is to be taken as bxy. Byx comes to be 1.3 and bxy comes to be, it is 0.5. Then regression of y on x, y on x is nothing but, that is y is equal to 1.3 into x plus 1.1. And similarly, regression of x on y, this is x is equal to 0.5 plus 0.5y and plus of, it is 0.5. these two are the regression equations, so that you can estimate at given value of x the corresponding value of y, at given value of y the corresponding value of x. This is all about regression analysis. Still another one or two problems I will give in the next class, but up to today's class this is enough. I would like to stop up to this one, and in the next class I will be continuing the problems and angle between two regression lines. There is one equation which you have to discuss. Thank you.